I'm Dr. Leandro Vendruscolo, staff scientist in the National Institute on Drug Abuse in the United States. And in the current issue of the Journal of Clinical Investigation, we report that blocking a particular brain stress system, the glucocorticoid system, is able to decrease alcohol-seeking, alcohol-dependent subjects. So alcohol abuse is a major public health concern. Recent data from the World Health Organization indicate that alcohol abuse is responsible for 6% of death and disability in the world. Considering that today's world population is over 7.3 billion people, as much as 440 million people will die or become disabled because of alcohol. Initially, people drink alcohol because of its euphoric, pleasant effects, but in the transition to alcohol dependence, individuals become tolerant to these positive effects, and in fact, a negative emotional state becomes present during abstinence. In other words, during alcohol dependence, the main motive for drinking alcohol is to reduce bad feelings such as anxiety, dysphoria, pain, and depression that occur in the absence of alcohol. In our study, we investigate the involvement of the hypothalamic pituitary adrenal axis, also called the HPA axis, on alcohol dependence. And similar to what happens in stressful situations, such as a situation of danger or fight or flight, episodes of alcohol intoxication and alcohol withdrawal also activate this neuroendocrine system to release glucocorticoids. Our hypothesis is that repeated cycles of alcohol intoxication and withdrawal will dysregulate this basic survival system, and the consequence of this dysregulation is the emergence of a negative emotional state that drives excessive alcohol seeking and taking. To test this hypothesis, we used the preclinical model of alcohol dependence in rats and also a clinical study in humans with alcohol dependence. This figure here shows that dependent rats drink substantially larger amounts of alcohol compared with non-dependent controls, about 70 doses of alcohol for dependent compared to 25 doses for non-dependent subjects. When these animals were given mifepristone, which is a drug that blocks the effects of glucocorticoids in the brain, we see a significant reduction in alcohol drinking. Importantly, this effect is specific for dependent subjects. The behavior of non-dependent animals was not altered by the treatment with mifepristone. To determine whether mifepristone could have a beneficial effect in the treatment of alcoholism, Dr. Barbara Mason at the Scripps Research Institute in California designed a study to test mifepristone in alcohol-dependent human subjects. The results showed that relative to placebo, individuals who received daily doses of mifepristone exhibit a marked reduction in craving for alcohol and in alcohol consumption. This discovery strongly suggests that alcoholism is a disorder that causes overactivation of stress system, including glucocorticoid signaling in the brain, and the pharmacological blockade of the action of glucocorticoid constitute a promising novel therapy for alcohol use disorders. Finally, I would like to thank all the collaborators of this study and the funding provided by National Institute on Alcohol Abuse and Alcoholism. Thank you.